Just over 100 years ago, the flu epidemic delayed Blenheim's victory celebrations at the end of the Great War. Sadly, this year another global public health threat, COVID-19, has forced us to find other ways to mark Anzac Day. For the first time, we cannot gather at the memorial gateway to the Picton foreshore at dawn, or come together at our clock tower cenotaph in Seymour Square, or collectively pay our respects at the various other war memorials around our region. Those normally front and centre of our Anzac services, our veterans, are also those who would be at the greatest risk. It's been an insecure, even frightening time for many, but it doesn't mean we've forgotten the importance of this day. My father and my grandfather were returned servicemen, and like other families, Anzac Day offers a moment for me to reflect on their experiences. And each year, as I take part in our Anzac commemorations, I think about two things: the scale of the sacrifice, and how the sacrifice extended way beyond the actual death toll. For every man who died, there were others scarred by their dreadful experiences. Add to them the uncounted victims of war: the elderly, the women, the children, the minorities, the vulnerable. They all paid a huge price, whether they died or survived. And today, even though we cannot stand as a crowd, we can still stand together in our own bubbles and pay our respects. We may not gather before our memorials, but we can again commit to remembering those names carved upon them. And we can hope and hold on to our hope for a future which embraces the message of all our memorials, a future of grace, hope, remembrance, and peace. We will remember them.